knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
With three important cell types covered, it's time to tackle another trio. Mast cells, basophils, and eosinophils are important central effector cells, not only in the overall innate and adaptive immunity, but also specifically in allergic inflammation or hypersensitivity type 1 reactions, and in protection against pathogens as well as parasites. Basophils and eosinophils, like neutrophils, are classified as granulocytes. During development, eosinophils and basophils fully mature in the bone marrow. In contrast, mast cells, or MCs, leave the bone marrow as progenitors and reach their final maturation within peripheral tissues. MCs are restricted to tissues and do not circulate in the bloodstream, whereas basophils, constituting less than 1% of circulating leukocytes, can be found in the circulation of every healthy individual, and can be rapidly recruited within tissues that are inflamed. Eosinophils, however, not only circulate in the blood, but also reside in hematopoietic and lymphatic organs, such as the bone marrow, spleen, lymph nodes, and thymus, ready to migrate to sites of allergic reactions. Eosinophils constitute about 1 to 6% of circulating leukocytes. In terms of the initial sequence of activation, MCs are among the first cells to recognize danger signals relayed from the external environment. This is because of their strategic location at the major body surfaces, including the skin and the lining of the lung and gastrointestinal tract. Upon activation, mast cells help orchestrate the early phases of the innate immune response, promoting the recruitment of eosinophils and basophils that follow inflammatory and chemotactic stimuli originating from inflammation. Mast cells, eosinophils, and basophils are therefore activated more or less simultaneously in many diseases, including infections, allergic and autoimmune disorders, and cancer. Mast cells are up to 20 micrometers in diameter and are ovoid or irregularly elongated cells with an ovoid nucleus. They also contain abundant metachromatic cytoplasmic granules. The metachromatic granule staining occurs as a result of abundant sulfated proteoglycans, such as heparin and chondroitin sulfates, in the granules. In humans, MCs are classified into two major subtypes, MCT cells, or tryptase, and mast cell-specific chymase, or MCTC cells, each found in different locations. Tryptase and chymase are the enzymatic mediators stored in MCs. Tryptase staining is generally used to identify tissue MCs. MCT cells are the prominent mast cell type within the mucosa of the respiratory and gastrointestinal tracts, and they increase in number with mucosal inflammation, whereas MCT cells are localized within connective tissues such as the dermis, submucosa of the gastrointestinal tract, heart, conjunctivae, and perivascular tissues. Mast cells express KIT, or CD117+, the receptor for stem cell factor, and FcεR1+. They express other cell surface receptors depending on their location and stage of differentiation and activation. Furthermore, mast cells express the activating IgG receptor FcγR2a, or CD32a, in the resting state, and in the presence of interferon gamma, the high-affinity activating FcγR1, or CD64. Mast cells may also express C3a and C5a receptors, IL3R, IR4R, IL5R, IL9R, IL-10R, GM-CSFR, IFN-γR, CCR3, CCR5, CXCR2, CXCR4, nerve growth factor receptor, and toll-like receptors, among others. Activation of mast cells occurs via aggregation of FcεR1, which is in turn dependent on antigen recognition by bound IgE. FcεR1 expression is upregulated during anaphylaxis and other allergic reactions in the presence of IL-4. MCs are also highly activated by C3a and C5a through C3ar and C5ar, or CD88, IgG, and TLRs. MC granules contain preformed mediators, including histamine, serine proteases like tryptase and chymase, carboxypeptidase A, and proteoglycans. Upon activation of mast cells, the granules fuse with the plasma membrane and the contents are released into the extracellular environment within a matter of minutes. Histamine has effects on smooth muscle, endothelial cells, nerve endings, and mucus secretion. Activation of mast cells not only results in the release of the preformed granule-associated mediators we just discussed, but it can also initiate the de novo synthesis of lipid-derived substances, such as leukotrienes. Another example is the major cyclooxygenase-derived product, PGD2, which is a potent bronchoconstrictor. Furthermore, TNF-alpha is a major cytokine that is stored and released by mast cells. Other cytokines produced by mast cells include IL-3, GM-CSF, and IL-5, which are critical for eosinophil development and survival. Also, IL-6, IL-10, and IL-13. Human mast cells also produce several chemokines, including CXCL8, IL-8, and CCL3, macrophage inflammatory protein 1-alpha, or MIP-1-alpha. Unregulated excessive activation of mast cells, most notably in the skin, bone marrow, gastrointestinal tract, spleen, liver, and lymph nodes, usually caused by activating mutations in KIT, leads to a condition called mastocytosis. Furthermore, pathological accumulation of mast cells in organs and tissues, or aberrant release of mast cell mediators, also result in monoclonal mast cell activation syndrome, or MAX. An example of MAX is systemic anaphylaxis to bee stings. With mast cells understood, let's move forward to elucidate the other two cell types we also mentioned, basophils and eosinophils.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.